Welcome back to get some more perspective on the federal government's committee or task force to bring down the prices of food. Let's cross over to Abuja. Magbe.
Thank you, Chamberlain. I have with me Laolu Akande, who is Senior Special Assistant to the President on Media and Publicity in the Office of the Vice President. Well, welcome to Sunrise Daily.
Thank you, Magbe.
Well, looking quickly at this special task force, we already know that it's going to be an interministerial effort, and they have an initial 7 days. What more do we know about this committee?
Well, thank you very much. The situation of the rising food prices is something that is very of great concern to this administration. And in an effort to try and address the problem in a very comprehensive and holistic way, the acting president on Wednesday did set up this task force. And this is not a committee. It's not a committee. It's a task force, which means that we want to address, you know, the problems of affordability and availability of the food items. Based on some of our experience and reports, there are places in the country where there is excess, you know, to the point that in some instances you find some of this produce, you know, going to waste, while in other parts of the country, you know, you don't have that kind of situation. There's quite maybe some kind of scarcity and prices are going up. So the acting president decided to set up this this task force, you know, to try and identify what is the problem, you know, for instance, is it transportation, you know, what happens in that process, what can government fix, working with the private sector, working with the farmers to ensure that the affordability is there and the availability is spread across the country. So, as I'm talking to you right now, I believe probably in another 30 minutes, the members of the task force will be meeting with the acting president to take the plan forward. This is something that is basically a practical effort to try and see what can be done quickly, urgently is the word, to bring down the prices.
Well, I don't know if you listened to our first guest, Mr. Wale Oyekoya, but before I get to what he said, what specific food products, what reports on specific food products reached the Federal Executive Council?
No, well, you know, there are reports, you know, generally that we read about rising food prices. It's a general.
It wasn't food specific.
It's a general phenomenon, you see. So this task force is going to identify exactly what can be done to address it on a holistic basis. I listened to some of your guests, you know, trying to be specific about this price, I mean, this food item or the other. No, we are concerned generally with what can we do, working with everybody involved, with all the stakeholders, including, you know, some of those associations, some of those groups and farmers, to bring the prices down. How can we, for instance, provide better transportation? Is there something that government can do to help facilitate the movement of the produce from the farms to the market in a more efficient way, in a way that we bring down the price?
Well, Mr. Wale Oyekoya had two concerns. The first one, he said, he's the chairman of the LCCI, that's Lagos Chamber of Commerce and Industry, agric sector, and he also owns a farm. He says, first of all, that government cannot control what it does not produce. So how is it that government hopes to help bring down the price?
I just explained to you that we want to look, for instance, you know, and the task force is open to, you know, whatever other factors that have been identified to be responsible for problems of affordability and availability. We want to look, for instance, whether there's something that can be done in the area of transportation, of moving the produce where you have them, you know, quite a bumper harvest, you know, where you have them in excess, where you have them even wasting, whether we can find an efficient way to move it, you know, so that it doesn't start, you know, stay there rotting or waste. Where, on the other hand, you have places where if you can move those produce there, you know, it's going to be sold. It's going to be win-win situation for everybody concerned. So it's a practical effort, you know, and it's not really time for debate. This is just time to get some solutions, and this is why we are very concerned. We want to get solutions. We believe that solutions are out there, you know, and we are concerned, you know, about the plight of the people, you know, and this is an effort to do something and do it urgently.
A lot of people will definitely want things to be done urgently. But then these concerns have been there for quite a while in terms of rising food prices, in terms of the cost of transportation, in terms of the fact that there was a lack of storage. Generally, infrastructure was absent for the farmer to ensure that he's able to make the most of his product. Why the sudden concern?
Well, certainly there have been ongoing, you just showed a clip of the Agric Minister. So there have been ongoing efforts. Government is an ongoing thing. Some of these problems have been there for quite a while. And so it's not as if, the government has not been paying attention to it. But it had just gotten to the point that we felt that we needed to do something urgently. We needed to do something practical. We needed to bring everybody around the table and find a solution. And I don't want to get into the specifics because, these plans are being, they are in the works, in the offing as we speak. So when they are out, when they are ready, we will go into the details. But the important thing here is that we want to do something. I want to do it urgently. And we do understand that there are quite a number of options of what can be done, especially in the area of bringing the food from where it exists to where maybe the prices are high. Ensuring that there is affordability and there is availability.
Well, a number of people also believe that the ministers who have been tasked with this are far removed from the realities of a lot of Nigerians, and they're wondering how it is that they will be able to feel very strongly the pinch that the everyday man is going through.
Well, look, I know that it's very convenient for people to make that kind of allusion. At the economic management team on Monday, this matter was discussed, and you had members, some of them ministers, some of them special advisors, are talking about their experience in the market. Somebody went to Mina and bought about 25 tubers of yam for 6,000. The same thing that is sold in probably Gariki for 21,000 or Vihai for 25,000. So we know we go to the same market. We are not removed at all from the situation. We have, many of us have wives, we have children, we have relatives. So we do know what is going on. There's no point to give the impression as if we are removed from the situation. No, we do know what is going on. We hear what is going on. We are connected to the people. We live with the people, and we are concerned. And that's why we are saying that, look, what can we do? And let us move very quickly.
Well, quickly, there are also concerns about the time frame given to this task force. They believe it's too short. I think you were given an initial 7 days to conduct their work.
So the task force is going to draw up a plan within 7 days, and then we submit the plan to the Federal Executive Council on Wednesday. And like I said, probably in another less than an hour, the task force will be meeting with the acting president in Aso Rock to present the options, to look at the options. So
they already have a report?
No, I'm not saying they have a report. I said they will be meeting with the acting president later this morning and to consider all the options.
Okay. Now let's quickly talk about this other matter which has been in the news. We know that Innocent Idibia, also known as Two-Face, is championing a protest, to bring to light the issues facing the everyday man. And it looks like there's also another protest, by supporters of the president who are saying they stand with this current government as well. Is the government trying to counter that protest?
Government is not in the business of countering any protests, particularly the Buhari presidency. We are very much aware of the rights of the people, and we want to protect the rights of the people. That's the business of government. People have the right to have a lawful assembly and lawful protest, and we are absolutely not against anybody who wants to exercise their rights to freedom of assembly, and express their whatever grievances they have, in a lawful way. Look, this government is clearly a government that we believe a lot of Nigerians understand. Have expressed sufficient concern. Look, we developed the social
investment. Have you heard, just quickly,
program.
Have you heard the attempts by, you heard the Lagos State Commissioner of Police say that it might not be possible to hold that protest because they hear that hoodlums might hijack the protest?
Well, it is the duty of the police to ensure that things are done lawfully and things are done in order, so the police
don't. But you do know the insinuations really in that is a government's attempt to try and stop the protest.
Look, it's all about balance. I've just told you, and I'm very categorical about that, that the Buhari presidency is not going to stop people from expressing their fundamental human rights. That's not what we're about. This is a government that, you know, that is interested in people expressing themselves. You know, this government, clearly we have shown, like never before, that we are concerned about the plight and the situation of the common man. That is why we have a budget that has, you know, half a trillion billion naira, 500 billion naira on social investment program, which is going on in about 28 states of the federal government today. Today, as I'm talking to you, one aspect of the program is taking place, is being implemented in at least 28 states of this country. So we don't have to wait. We know, you know, that the people brought us in, and that is why once we got into government, we brought this kind of program that has never been done before in this government.
So are you going to be telling the protesters who are protesting in support of the government, this is a very odd one, protesting in support of the Buhari administration, saying I stand with Buhari, are you going to tell them to stand down?
Why do you have to tell anybody what to do? This is a free country. You see, we understand that because of the experience that people have had with past government, they are trying to use that to judge this government. This is a very different government. This is a government of change. People have a right to protest. Whether they want to support or they want to oppose is their right. And what the police ought to do, and which I believe they are doing, is to say that, look, let's do this in a lawful way, in a peaceful way. That's fine. You know, we have no problem with people expressing their own sentiments. It's a free world, and Nigeria is a free country.
Well, Mr. Laolu Akonde, we must thank you for coming on Sunrise Daily. He is the Senior Special Assistant to the President on Media and Publicity in the Office of the Vice President.